Hello, I'm Florina Montanescu for the Developer Show. This is your weekly update on the coolest developer news from Google. Google Play Points Rewards program is now expanding to the United States, following successful launches in Japan and Korea. Your users can be rewarded for any purchase they make on Play, including apps, games, in-app items, subscriptions, and more. So if your app is on Play billing, users will earn points on your apps and games immediately. Find out more about Play Points in the post. The latest version of the Cloud Firestore SDK now supports in-queries, allowing you to query a specific field for multiple values in a single query. Find out more about how to use in-queries, the behavior of the security rule, and their limitations in the post. Google Cardboard, a simple cardboard viewer that anyone can use to experience virtual reality, is now open sourced. The open source project provides APIs for hash tracking, lens distortion rendering, input handling, and more. Now you can contribute to the project, expanding its capabilities. Check out the post for details. App Engine was updated with more new runtimes. Node.js 12, Go 1.13, PHP 7.3, and Python 3.8. This means that you can build applications with your favorite tools, libraries, and frameworks with today's most popular languages. Find out the details on App Engine support for each language and how to get started in the post. Dart 2.6 was launched with Dart to Native, an extension of our existing compiler set with the ability to compile Dart to self-contained native executables for macOS, Windows, and Linux. The executables created with Dart to Native are self-contained and can run on machines that don't have the Dart SDK installed. And because they're compiled with Dart's AOT compiler, the executables start running in just a few milliseconds. Check out the post for more details on how to get started. OpenTitan, the first open-source Silicon Root of Trust project, was launched. OpenTitan will deliver a high-quality ROT design and integration guidelines for use in data center service, storage, peripherals, and more. Find out how you can contribute and more details on the project in the post. Please remember to like, subscribe, and share. I'm Florina Montanescu for the Developer Show. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.